Hey guys, welcome back to another video. So I wanted to jump on here and take a look at gold with you guys and really just a response to today's news for the US dollar. We had some Fed meeting material that was sort of juicy and caused some serious movement in the financial markets. Things like the dollar, the S&P 500, and gold, which is going to be the focus of today's video, moved big time in response to this. And I want to talk specifically about gold because it really, really rocked the price. As you can see here, this is a 4-hour chart and you can see price came down hard. And I do have an opinion about this. So I wanted to jump on here and share a little bit of that with you. So first of all, we need to understand what actually happened and then we can try and make a more informed decision as to what we may want to do here with gold if you are trading it. Now, I have mentioned recently that the market, when it comes to the US dollar, right, the US dollar is very, very important if you're going to be trading gold. Many times people trade, one currency pair, or they trade just gold, or they trade two or three different things. If you are trading gold, you are certainly going to be needing to pay attention to the dollar as well as the price of gold, because of course, these two things are like two cousins that battle it out every single day. Because at the end of the day, what you have to think about is that the dollar is one option, but then you also have gold, right? So you have to think, investors are making a decision. Do they want to bet with gold or they want to bet with the dollar? And today's news sort of leaned things a bit to the right side here on the US dollar, in my opinion. Here's why. Basically, we had a Fed meeting, and in that Fed meeting, they discussed some more aggressive stances towards monetary policy tightening to respond to inflation. In fact, there was some hawkishness from the Fed, basically outlining that, hey, you know, things are looking good enough. We are looking to possibly begin that tapering process, which if you don't know what tapering is, I've explained it many times on my channel, but I'll do it a quick another time here for those of you guys who are newer. Tapering is basically all economies, especially during the 2020 correction that we saw in response to the global pandemic, started printing money a lot. And what does printing a lot of money do to your currency? Well, it devalues it fairly quickly. Tapering, however, is the process of slowing that money printing. Why are they printing so much money? Well, the printing goes right into our economy and it helps to sort of stimulate everything and keep things alive, right? Well, tapering is this process here where you actually sort of hold off on all of that printing and things are good enough as to where you say, hey, you know what, we can sort of take a step back from this. That is sort of the clues that we were getting from the Fed today, which in turn caused the US dollar to get very strong. So before we even take a look at technicals for gold, let me show you what happened to the DXY. Look at that solid rock, you know, rocket ship to the upside there for the dollar. We saw a price pull back here to support, finding major buyers in this area here. You can see we have just seen some real strong aggression from the bulls. Now, I currently have a long position myself on this, which is actually going to come into play in just a second. I've just moved stops to break even. I am filming this trade, so you'll be able to see it up on YouTube in a few days. I film all my trades, or at least as many as I can. It takes me a lot of time, but I'll do it for you guys. You guys are the YouTube subscribers. I'll do the best I can for you. By the way, if you're enjoying the video, hit that like button, hit the subscribe button. I make all sorts of free content. So if you like this sort of stuff, we got more stuff coming for you. So anyways, I took a long position on the dollar against the Swiss franc, which I shared inside of our private Discord. Real quick, shout out to those of you guys who are inside of the group with me. You can see I basically called out dollar Swiss long bias there as price was retesting that 61.8. You can see it right here. And why am I mentioning this? What does this have to do with gold? Actually, quite a bit. USDCHF is very, in some ways, correlated to gold, or I should say, inversely correlated. Now, what that means is that if you bet that the dollar against the Swiss franc is going to go up, you're actually kind of making a bet against gold. And the reason for that is that, again, you're betting on the dollar, and you can see they're on the other side from each other, right? So you'd be buying in this case. That would actually be more like buying the dollar, shorting gold. In this case, you're buying the dollar, shorting CHF. Well, another interesting fact, CHF and gold, Switzerland has quite a bit of a gold reserve themselves. So that actually causes them to have some correlation and some movement with the price of gold. Just the more you know what I mean? So anyways, back to gold here. Like I said, I am long in this, which is in some ways a proxy gold short. There is some correlation there. It's not perfect, but it is something nonetheless. Anyways, taking a look at gold here now. What did we see happen today? What's of importance? What can we pay attention to going into the rest of this week? Well, I wanted to show you guys this. I pointed this out earlier on in my stream, actually today and yesterday. The 61.8 finally got tapped and just barely before sellers pushed this thing right on through to the downside, breaking some lower time frame support levels that were pretty noticeable. So let me actually draw in this. So again, now we're looking at the 1 hour chart. Again, big movement to the downside, big push there for the gold sellers. We saw the rebound, and in today's news, we saw some pretty strong sell side action for the gold bears here today. Now, this breakout here was a pretty big signal. In fact, if you're watching this on the lower time frames, you may have even gotten a second chance to enter on the short side if you liked gold to the short side. See, because look what happened. Price spiked like crazy. The news followed through once we had some really, really bearish catalysts for gold here, or I should say bullish catalysts for the dollar, retests resistance and finds sellers right away. So we are still back at the lows, and I wanted to give you my opinion. I think gold is likely headed back down. Path of least resistance has to be, for me, back to 1745. Is that a guarantee that price is going to go there? No, I wish it was. I'd be the richest person on the planet if I could guarantee you where price was going to go next. But what I can do is I can give you educated guesses and educated decisions based on the analysis and the facts that we have played out in front of us. Point is, the dollar is really strong right now. And although I was bearish on the dollar a few weeks ago, the latest news has to be taken into account. And again, right now, we are seeing some strength from the Fed. We're seeing some hawkishness that I think is not... It may be here to stay. So what does that mean? If that means I'm looking at the gold market and I'm saying, hey, I think that the dollar may actually have some strength here to continue up, what does that mean for gold? Well, that would have to draw me to the conclusion that I think gold may be more to the short side, more to the sell side in the short term. Doesn't mean I'm saying it's going to zero. It just means that I think that the path of least resistance is for price to go see if buyers are still strong, sort of retreat, if you will, back down to support at 1745. Of course, will I be right about this? I can't guarantee that. I don't know the future. What I can do, however, is give you educated guesses. And so another thing that I should add, technical analysis, if you caught the retest of this trend line, absolutely beautiful technical analysis. Here you can see sellers and bam, they showed up again today. Like I said, I think that there should be some follow through here on gold. Will it be right away? Maybe, maybe not. What I would say for the bulls out there, watch for my idea here to be completely wrong. Can we see price do something like this and completely turn things around? If that's the case, maybe you start looking for a flip side direction. But again, with the news catalyst today, the strength to the downside there for the gold market, I think that the path of least resistance is going to be a move back down lower. Now, the last thing I will say here is for those of you guys who are watching this on a lower time frame basis, if you're looking at the 1 hour chart, for example, we do have some support here. And the question is, can price get underneath it? If it gets underneath it, again, you may have more opportunities if you're an intraday seller to look for things like this, right? That, in my opinion, gives you some decent risk reward. Of course, I don't want to be just shorting just because I think that it's bearish. I still want to be taking technical setups, and I think that we may have just missed one here on the retest. Now, of course, I mentioned I don't have any positions open on gold because I do already have one on USD CHF, which, like I said, has some inverse correlations to gold. By going long on the dollar Swiss, I am in some ways taking a position on the dollar, and sort of going against gold there by proxy due to the CHF exposure to gold. So with that said, that's what I have for you in terms of today's news. I do think that it has the potential to follow through. I think that the dollar, the Fed finally making a move here, or at least taking a bit more of an aggressive stance, is something to take note of. And for now, like I said, that DXY looks fairly strong. Even now, as we talk about it, breaking through resistance and finding enough buyers to stay up there. Pretty crazy. We're seeing that aggressive stance on the DXY. I think one more thing to mention, looking at the DXY, a move back up to 93.7 could be in the books. In my opinion, that is where price is likely headed next. So we'll see how right I am. Maybe I'm right. Maybe I'm completely wrong. And of course, you guys can flame me in the comments if you'd like. That's completely up to you. With that said, like I mentioned earlier, if you'd like to see the trades that I'm taking, come join our Discord there. So you can see right here all the trades that I take. I share inside of our private Discord community. Whether I am, you know, right about a trade or wrong, I'll share them all in here with my full breakdowns and analysis. So with that said, guys, thank you very much for tuning in. The link is down below in the description should you decide to join. We'll see you back next time.